the harrowing escape from Iran of an American mother and her six-year-old daughter stunned the world in the movie Not Without My Daughter. But that movie and the book that inspired it were told from the mother's perspective. Now, two decades later, her daughter tells her own story.
20 years ago, Sally Field starred in the movie Not Without My Daughter, a movie based on the true story of Betty Mahmoody and her daughter, Mahtob. Betty was married to an abusive Muslim husband who prevented her and Mahtob from leaving Iran. Now Mahtob shares their ordeal in her book, My Name is Mahtob, and how she learned to forgive the father who shattered her life.
Please welcome to the 700 Club, Mahtob Mahmoody. It's so wonderful to have you here.
Thank you so much.
I was just telling Mahtob that watching that movie years ago was so anxiety provoking. I felt physically ill by the time the movie was over. You lived through it.
I'm sorry to do that to you.
No, I mean, it just, as a mother, I just could not imagine such trauma or tension. Mm-hmm. This all happened 20 years ago.
30 years ago now.
But 20 years ago, the movie came out. Why now? Why the book now? What made you decide to do this?
I had had the opportunity for many years, and I didn't want to write a book.
Yeah.
You know, because I grew up with my mom traveling
like
and with
story.
Publishers.
Yeah.
And no, I love traveling and meeting new people, but I didn't want to write my own book. Mm-hmm. And then this opportunity kept coming up, and it wouldn't go away. and so finally I'm thinking, huh, maybe I hear you, God.
Yeah.
But no, there was a special woman in my life who, it was her dream. She was the editor of Mom's Book in Germany, mm-hmm. and it was her dream for me to write a book, and she was dying.
Well, two different perspectives for certain. The perspective from a mother's standpoint, but then to be a six-year-old child experiencing this mm-hmm. was quite traumatic, I'm sure. You know, I think the thing that was so stunning about the story from the movie's perspective was how almost idyllic your life seemed before that here in the United States. Mm-hmm. Was it so?
It was. It really was. I was recently back in the Northern Michigan community where we lived before we went to Iran and Alpena, and people from the community came and they said exactly that. You know, you were such a happy family. Your dad adored you. And it touched me that mm-hmm. they held on to those good memories, and then they came and shared them with me now 30 years later.
So what was it, do you think, that turned your dad from this family man who adored you and doted on you to the person who was so ideologically immersed in the Iranian culture and the political system at that mm-hmm. time? How did that happen?
Well, I was born in 1979, just before the embassy hostage taking. There was a big shift in his country. And I think being so far removed, you know, he was here in America, this is happening in Iran, and I think he felt a responsibility mm-hmm. to his family and to his country. There was this kind of tugging of his roots, so to say. And it was the combination of religion, of politics, of, you know, pressure from his family. But this was something he had planned. I think also in the back of his mind, when he became a father, he realized how important it was for him to raise me with his value system.
Mm-hmm.
And I can respect that. His value system is not my value system.
Yeah.
So I think the way he went about it was very wrong and very extreme.
Mahtob, what was it like for you to go to Iran as a six-year-old? Because the American culture is so free and open, mm-hmm. and based on your mother's story and now your own, I mean, it was mm-hmm. quite different.
Very different. At first, it was a big celebration.
Yeah,
it was a family reunion.
Yeah.
But the cultures, which are really high honors in the Persian culture, were very foreign to me, you know, slitting a lamb's throat and stepping over the blood into the home.
Traumatic, really.
But in the Persian culture, this is a huge honor.
Yeah.
So there was a learning curve for sure, but definitely a lack of freedom.
At some point along the way, I mean, you and your mother thought you were going for a few week vacation, and then it turned into your dad saying, no, we're here to stay, and to your mother, if you want to leave, you're free to, but you're not taking Mahtob with you.
Mm-hmm.
What was the lowest point for you in the process of all of this?
Mm-hmm. I think the most difficult for me, I mean, there were bombings and I was forced to go to school and I had to, you know, shout death to America and stomp on the American flag before I could enter,
the classroom.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. But I think the most difficult part for me was the domestic violence aspect.
Yeah. You know, which you had not seen in the United States.
Never, never.
Yeah.
And so to see my dad beat my mom, to you know, hear him say how he's going to kill her, you know, that was more difficult for me than any of the rest.
And yet, despite the seriousness of all of that and the regularity of it, your mom actually gave you a choice when she had made up her mind that she was going to find a way to get out. Mm-hmm. And you were the one who said, mm-hmm. I'm going with you.
She's incredible.
Yeah, she really is.
I don't think I would have had the strength to do to do that.
Can I say, not just incredible from that standpoint, I marveled in your book at how your mother never defamed your father mm-hmm. to you and always wanted you to appreciate your Persian culture.
I'm so, so thankful for that.
I mean, that's quite unusual.
It is. It is. And the sacrifice she had to make emotionally to do that for me was huge. But the impact in my life then and now, it's just immeasurable.
Well, you two were really a team when you came back, because mm-hmm. for many years, though you did escape, I want people to read the book. I don't want to give away the whole process.
But thank you.
Though you did escape, you lived in fear, and so did your mother. You actually lived with an assumed name for a window of time.
I did, and not just for my security, but for the security of the other students at school.
Exactly.
The school asked me to use a different name, although I couldn't legally change my name.
Yeah.
The night before my first day of school, my mom gave me a new name and taught me how to write it. And
There was a lot of anxiety and a lot of fear over the years. And eventually, mm-hmm. as a young woman, you had health issues and were diagnosed with lupus. Do you mm-hmm. feel like that continual fear and anxiety had anything to do with that breakdown of your body?
Well, I do know that stress is a trigger for me, mm-hmm. you know, that kind of stress, that unremitting stress is mm-hmm. definitely one of my triggers. And there's a school of thought out there, whether it's
accurate
scientific or not,
right.
That disease is often representative. And how apt that I have a disease where my body literally, my flesh and blood attacks my body.
I was amazed by your mother as I read the book, but I was also amazed by you and the role that your personal faith played in your life throughout this. Tell us about that.
Well, thank you. God is so good. We escaped, we came home. I needed a school, and so mom sent me to a parochial school so I could be safer.
Yeah.
She thought it would be harder for my dad to find me, but that was God putting me in the hands of Mrs. Hudson, my first grade teacher. Just all of my teachers. I had amazing, amazing, loving teachers, and they taught me to be secure in God's love. You know, even if my dad kidnapped me,
God was with you.
God was always with me.
Your dad died in 2009. Mm-hmm. You were able to forgive him long before
before, yes.
But how did his death impact you? Was there a sense of freedom that came with the lack of fear, or what did you feel?
It was this huge clash of emotions. My instant reaction was, this is finally over. But then at almost exactly the same moment, I thought, you know, this is just, it's a tragedy for him. I felt so sad for him.
What is your life like today?
Oh, I have a wonderful life today. I don't know what a normal day is for me yet. I'm so far, this process has removed me so far from my normal day today. But yesterday I was in Boston. I met fascinating people, got to see some of our nation's history.
You've had a long life of learning and exploring and enjoying other cultures and very supportive family and friends along the way. It's wonderful to meet you in person.
I have so much to be thankful for.
Seen the movie and read the book. I recommend both. There's so much more to Mahtob's fascinating story. You can read all about it. Her new book is called My Name is Mahtob. And this is available wherever books are sold. You might catch the movie as well to get a big picture from both a mother and a daughter standpoint. It's called Not Without My Daughter. Good to have you here, Mahtob.
Thank you so much.